Ebusa for mama kwa ba SVTV Africa so anya be pure world e dodowa SVTV Africa daily also any few ones ba be di nkomo ne ahwe dodowa te sen dwom te sen nyamam te sen wa ha eno nkomo ne ba be di SVTV Africa so ya fa me DJ nyamam mon koso na mon subscribe to your channel na mon follow all social media and say SVTV Africa daily also anya man for twin komo sa before me share say mama na me sponsor ase power jet car battery power power keke the only strongest car battery in town e boss pa yi baby ewu won ko toya no battery bia o spark ata enye so ta enye so ko na ko hwe power jet car battery am main office was Sharon Sport e temalashibi from am na message na screen so no hia dodo etu akoton na person no me business a from eye the Roxin Ventures am na omde power jet car battery e buy hwe mo chira kwan sisi a power jet car battery eye power keke sweet at bichia boko die
ya fine me adon boko
o fe o
Megase.
Odi ni ere?
Betty AJ.
Betty AJ. What nickname bi ana?
Pasha Devi.
Wan no no ko school on nickname.
Emse bi a trust man da garden me nyi everything ti no mo friend mi Cheche. Enu anu. Cheche.
Cheche. Anyway, ma beto ododo wa hana ofri.
E hana miti.
Ofri.
Mi fi osu.
O tu ye nkan ni.
Pacha ni.
Oh, that's nice. Intin kan ni no bro sen.
Aduele. Na aduele.
Na?
Aduele.
Aduele. Na aduele akos mo komi wa ke sitoni apo
e be no jiga me woni ni o
ojo ni ni ona ke kena ojo favorite food ona
e fine
we can be your small
oh keba o mo ke fufin len small fufin fo mo small ni ni nata
ni komi hu e
ono jin favorite no keba nko to
she fe wo no one hani o bam mu se fe agbo na kan
oh dabi
o si ewo dodo wa dodo alive then na wanga sasa wo yesi sia
say me in school actually and I'm a beneficiary in the NAPCO program so yeah I work at the district assembly in Femina as a NAPCO trainee and aside that yeah that's what I do
so me ne kan bro fo o me ku ye ne bro fo
oh me chi
school be na wiye
me chi na nye
en bro fo de be fra fra school be na wiye
Tertiary analysis. Okay. Kenya University Tech.
It's then already or?
I just finished my master's in sustainable integrated rural development. For undergraduate, I did geography and rural development.
What is the romantic or
oh, me say master's no yes sustainable.
No that go for market for na kasa. Momo no mu bio man na me te voice ni nyina. But all the name te.
Oh, no, sustainable and integrated rural development.
Minimum bi kasaya o se aden na moko school munchu su courses anamu ready courses bi a obu wie school betimanya ejuma ye easy but di bi wa otimi ko ready a o wie kwa na ehun ejuma kra ya den are
it's because now I blame our system both our educational system and in our government system because menya sure say course bi a if it's not beneficiary it should be in the tertiary and again I blame the system because it doesn't allow us to come out and then express what you have learned or use what you've acquired. So it has made some courses become useless. I say a whole new fast, but like what I read, sustainable integration rural development. It's about how to develop your environment. It's supposed to even allow you to be able to bring about projects that will help your area or your community to develop. So I'm blaming the system because you go and read such a program, you come out and there's no place to employ you. Usually such programs should be in like the assemblies, the local government system, so that at least you will be able to bring about projects that will help communities to sustain themselves. But our system has made decide that if you don't know anybody, you go and read a course and you come out, you don't get job. It's not because what you've learned is useless, but it's because the system hasn't given you an opportunity to go and use what you've acquired. Yes. So it's actually the system, not
then a buyance and I will decide this is our course now back when.
I'm somebody who is interested in development activities, things that bring growth, that bring progress, more especially about land management. So it influenced my kind of study from geography. I'm an environmental person. I like things that affect our environment. And to reach sustainable development, I was trying to get, or my intention was to get things that we can do that will be sustainable. You know, there are projects we carry about, or after some time, maybe I say, but before Brian, be sit toilet, my normal call. A home fast for you, the program I studied is supposed to help us to identify projects or to be able to do things that can be beneficial to the community. and also how you can use maybe materials and then the people in the local area to develop themselves so that whoever supports them, once you leave, whatever project or whatever thing you started doesn't go waste.
She said, I know who you school here.
This year.
Oh, this year. Oh, 1 year. Oh, yeah, but town fresh. So how was school?
It was fun. Masters was tedious. It's more of research work, more steady, so you are more limited. You don't really have time to really chill like undergraduate. Undergraduate, it was fun. At least you had some spare time to.
Girls, moko parties, mo yanyan.
Not the I like outing, but I'm not a girls party type.
No, boys, I'm pie, mo chile.
Boys, yes.
Do they see your campus?
No.
Maybe try and throw out. Yes, mo fa boy will feel, but moko campus or more boy.
I wasn't trained that way, so.
I don't mean a bit trained, say yes, I don't know. And yes, subanye parties.
No, but it's also, you know, when you know where you are coming from, it influences your lifestyle and how you do things on campus.
4 years, no one for boy be our school. Boys in this one, how?
They'll come. Or mom, but the castle mom, but it's not true. They come, but you should know why you are there and what you intend to achieve. So I'm not an angel, but I just wanted to stay focused on my studies. So, yeah.
For boy, this one's slow.
Oh, no. I had more of guys as my friends, so it didn't give chance to for anybody to laugh at me.
So, like, open, my man, now for same ma.
Yes.
Yes, I'm bound. Yes, I didn't plan. I see a storm.
Why?
Because I'm more alternative. So I don't know why. Now break up, but our boy already about to be connecting.
Growing up, I've always been a tomboy, so it's what influenced how I did my things. I was the lady who was boisterous, always wanting to do what guys did. So I had more male friends than female.
What interest my bear man? How need interest my bear?
I would say I have interest for men. Or I'm not. When it comes to relationship, I'm not selective. I'm more inclined to men. I'm not a lady, no. I just don't like female friends because women, we are own trouble. So that's why I like more male friends.
Yes, I know.
Oh, yes. I know we are own trouble. And it's easier for the opposite sex to understand the other party better.
So. This is
your metal, so then how? I'm shop ban.
Chopper, Yabadi Nidianibi, a Kamapa, where free promo Yabadi Nidianibi, a Kamapa, and a chose to say, Yano Babuca, because oh, Bamusius Bamuses, no, I had the old bush in man, I said.
But I was
a young Bema who I didn't catch you.
It's natural for African men to appreciate us, so.
So, Unam, no crow market, and I be na and baby and Bema walk a crown on a man. Then, on my crowd, what then on my.
They make fun. Just normal vibes. They appreciate what God has given me. That's
hey, Tony, I'm
also Madame Warfare.
Yes, and also Tima.
Oh, I can't thank you. I'm used to it, but my name is H1.
Oh, remember, catch us, auntie. I said, what?
It's normal.
And also, BB, Project B.
I'm on a NAPCO program.
Oh, okay. You see, you have a month behind.
700.
Hey, cool, man.
No. Living on 700 is not easy. Moreover, if you are renting, you are not closer to home. So you take your rent out, you pay your rent, what you used to eat, maybe transportation. It's just not enough. That's it. So me here for me now. So that's Ashanti region. So I just came home to see my mom.
How long now yes are Ejumawe?
It's a 3-year contract, so it's ending this year.
This year, I say ending. What try so you feel human na unya na answer? So we answer na challenges.
I've been trying, but it's sad and it's annoying searching for a job in Ghana. Cause you go and they are telling you they want someone with 10 years working experience, 5 years working experience, and you ask yourself who should give you the experience for who should benefit. And aside that, too. You are in school, you do internships, you go on this voluntary stuff, all to acquire experience. And then you come and they tell you it's not a work experience. It's frustrating. It makes it difficult, like, for people, because you don't see the essence of having to go to school. If going to school, paying those huge sums of money, acquiring knowledge, and you come in, unya baby in found kwashe. Now, ebi aji se, okotpe baby ton. Because there are a lot of graduates now selling on the streets. We shouldn't be, because they should be in the hands of affairs in our administrative government offices to help the country grow. But we have people who do not qualify, occupying positions that qualified people should be in. So it's with the job situation in Ghana, I think it really needs more attention than it's been given now.
Do you mind office and commit me here?
I did development. So any thing related to, and I'm interested in land. So anything, yes,
land. I never saw a land guard.
Not at all. I just think there's a lot that can be done. You know, almost anything you do, it happens on our land. What you eat is coming from the land. Where we build, where we stay, what we drink is always coming from the land. So if there's no proper management and development of our land system, it's going to have very serious future repercussions. So I'm someone who thinks it needs more addressing. So I'm interested in that area. So working with the planning officers, the district assemblies, the fiscal planning departments and stuff, it's a place of interest I'd like to be.
You see, and so we'll be fair now. Or say, or offer be mawa now. So you may be mawa. Why ready?
Oh, yes. Yes.
You might not want Kumasi and I won't cry.
Well, I think I like life in Kumasi, but.
Why do you like life in Kumasi?
It's less hectic than in Accra.
Danger.
Because Accra is choked. And let me say, for a beginner or a starter, starting life in Accra is expensive. The renting, transportation. So if you are working in somewhere in Accra, you have a very small salary to say, and you have to travel a distance or you have to rent, I think it puts pressure on you as an individual. And I think that's why some people end up becoming corrupt, because they are tempted to put their hands in government money or in conferences they shouldn't put their hands in order to keep that standard of living in Accra here. So Kumasi, northern region, any parts outside stress. A stressful life in Accra.
700, no, the background, Sophie.
Obviously, yes.
Oh, yes, at least
it's manageable, yes. Yeah, at least you go to the market, you buy stuff, you get something.
A lot of people were villages, the rural areas, someone say, maybe in Kosu, be a Jania Bakra. I think so.
It's because of the picture we paint that Accra is. It's a greener pasture, like there's money in Accra. And also it's because we've centralized most of our development activities in Accra. Most of our offices, so everybody thinks that once you come to Accra, there's something to do. And again, because of the hectic life in Accra, you don't have time for your personal self. So it's easier for people to want to acquire house helps and those things to support their life. So all the people in the north are also looking at it like an opportunity, or not necessarily the north, but I mean all the other people coming down south. Are looking at like an opportunity to come and do those other jobs. But I believe if we are able to decentralize our system, like take up projects and other stuff in the other areas, all we are like, look, all the better schools or what we claim are the better schools are all in Accra and all the other stuff. But if we take it closer to the people, they wouldn't see the need to have to come here to come and do something, so they'll stay there. And also like Accra, you've developed almost all the roads and stuff in Accra, at least majority of parts in Accra are tarred roads, but those other areas don't have that. So if someone is looking at the stress, access to good health care and all those things, they think coming to live in Accra, I'll benefit better than being up there. So if all those other projects are carried out there, or you try to at least put it in areas where it is more reachable to people, it will reduce the stress in Accra.
Talking about life, what do I say? It's saying
Dodo is cool. Until quite recently, it was a very quiet town. And we knew ourselves, but now the town is growing. It's expanded. It's almost this closer to Accra now. It's like, so now I think there's a bit of pressure in the town now as compared to before, which is obviously expected. I don't know, it's cool. Anyway, I don't see more job opportunities in this town. And the painful part is usually growing up, the people in this town were involved in more farming activities. But now, because of this land selling and stuff, all those things are gone. So everybody is now venturing into trading. You buy something, you come and sell. Buy something, come and sell.
See, I'm an opportunity to say, you be my corona. Then I dream, say, Ufi San Kai Samoye.
Well, looking at this town, I think my problem now in this town, one thing I've identified that really needs addressing in this town is the youth empowerment. I realized that most people or the youth in the community and their education are just the basic level or just the senior high level. And aside that, they don't really get themselves into good jobs. So there's a lot of the growing agency of teenage pregnancy around. And you realize that most of the young boys are into this motor riding and other stuff instead of learning other skills or traits that could be beneficial to the community or maybe even their families. So looking at that, I want to do something that will get to empower them, youth training programs, sensitization programs, where they will come to appreciate their sense of education. And you know, some of them are like, you go to school, you are done, there is no job. So looking at how best the community can help itself, because like I was talking about the land matter like this, I was thinking, they grow a lot of mango around here. So instead of selling the land, you could look how best mango can be produced, processed, not just growing all the mangoes and selling them like we do, but if there's a factory around that processes the mango into juice, it can employ people to also do it. This mango can be used for other things, and the other crops that have been planted around, so at least factories around that can produce, not just grow their crops, but give them the essence of as a production, as a growing them, there's a production process. So that's one thing I'll look at in the area, aside the empowering them about bringing out job opportunities or stuff that would help them to do something better for themselves. Today's on mommy did I support her, but she did.
And then no idea me mamma too. And see and not the end inquire de.
Oh mommy and aroma.
Before me jawakra advice Ben or woman up and coming youth no my bunny idea, your life how fame, or be so called school, courses of which you soon idea. You also have fame till now, just in a field and it's coming out from school. What kind of advice? No mommy a slave queen, sugar that is near there. What kind of advice now?
Well, to my youth, I always believe in passion. If you do something you are passionate about, if you don't even, you are not employed, you are able to do something for yourself and you feel fulfilled, you don't think what you studied is useless. And I realize that now most parents, because of lack of job opportunities, they are forcing their kids to do nursing, to do teaching, just because they think once they are there, there is assurance of posting. And it's affecting our community, because if you look at now our medical services, you go, and unlike growing up, meeting nurses when you go to the hospital, the way they are passionate and ready to help, you don't meet those kind of people. What you mean that they are there because they need a job to get them paid. Uh-huh. So I think we should encourage our kids or ourselves, like the youth, to do things they are passionate about. They can grow your passion into a job. Okay, if you are doing something you're passionate about, even if what you are collecting is little, the satisfaction that, oh, I'm doing something I like, it makes it easier. It will reduce the level of corruption and things we are facing now. So for me, my advice to everybody is to identify your passion and make it a job.
Slay queen movements, eh? So what's it to be? Unimbi?
Like I said, I wouldn't blame them entirely. Our system is failing. And it's time we all sit up and do our part as citizens. Because I believe if there were better job opportunities, if there were better avenues for people to do good things, they wouldn't end up there. And again, I blame our media too, because we don't appreciate the doctor who is in the hospital going about saving lives 24/7. We come around and talk about our so-called celebrities who are not really doing anything that is affecting life. But I believe if we are projecting our doctors, the best doctor of the year, the best nurse of the year, the best teacher of the year, it would interest our youth or upcoming ones to have idols, like people they look up to. Oh, I want to be like Professor Lotte. I want to be like this person. But we don't hear about those people. So everybody wants, hey, I want to be like Nanama. I want to be like this, like the celebrities we keep hearing about. So I encourage our media partners like to throw more spotlight on our health workers, on our people in the institutions, those helping, saving lives, those teaching, educating our young ones, so that it makes those, professions attractive, so that we have people yearning to become doctors, yearning to become engineers, other than wanting to become slaves.
But now there are no attraction.
No, you ask the 6-year-old, because he hasn't heard of any renowned doctor. You only hear a kid saying, I want to be a doctor, that is if he has a mother, a father, or an uncle or auntie who is a doctor. You get it? We are not talking about the young doctors. Oh, there's a doctor who is just 24 years. There's a nurse who is just 18 years. She's doing her work. You know, I had opportunity to accompany my sister to school to go and give a talk one time. And when they realized, oh, young, somebody from this town, she's been able to go to Gehe. The kids were like, I want to go to Gehe like you. I want to go. It was nice. you get it, at least they realize that someone from this town has gone that far, can also go. So I believe if we talk more about other professions and stuff, it would interest others to want to get to that stage.
Nice one. Waka brofu sa. Inti brofu. Waka brofu sa. Waka brofu.
Se chi chi no en koyi.
Lo wa tu krogogwi.
Eh.
Wa tu krogwi. So mo no.
Eh o chita filo no ma de ngayo.
No ade ngayo. Me da se pass ene. Uni akasa wa SVTV Africa. Uni social media, like what social media handles? Or Instagram, Facebook
na. No, I'm not a social media fan.
Do ni Facebook uni be bia.
Apart from WhatsApp, I don't have any social media.
Really? And a network in your internet number turn out through?
No, not at all.
Some of friends, mates, yeah, they don't know any of the social media.
I like people who are real. A lot of people things are fake on the social media and stuff. So,
yes. And it's own person. Mm-hmm.
When I wasn't on WhatsApp, I had friends who were calling me 24/7. Like, almost every week you get their call. Once I came online, there are many people I've never even heard of again. Once they're calling, they come and saying you, hi. I think it's really not our thing. It's breaking our social ties.
Kikibi's restaurant, Pap and Lounge, yeah. Restaurant, I was just behind the KFC, I was up there. Kikibi's restaurant, Pap and Lounge, I was East Legon. So, East Legon, they are going to be a place or they are free delivery. Kikibi's restaurant, Pap and Lounge. So, also, no more Friday night live band section. Sunday night, karaoke night with the stars. I was up there. Kikibi's restaurant, Pap and Lounge. Hope I saw quite a simple cross. Just Google search Nabo Kikibi's restaurant, Kano Beko Street. After five, the mastermind. The mastermind is a ginger drink with spices. Be a by a bojuma pa. Party be I will be a hustle. And everybody do and maybe some say, after five, there's no one on my say. By I won't do 18 years, sir. And Ben, who grew 18 years, I'll bet man. After five, the mastermind. Call Nakope Binato. I'm not on the old screen. So you know, I'm on my business. So what sports joint? Me up and say, oh, no, me a business are from. After five, Aji, baby. Wow. You better, I'll buy man and so you're running. I saw SBTV Africa. So I'm going to so I'm following. Say support me. I got a program with your support. Now I'm going to be wiping. Say, I'm going to offer SBTV Africa Foundation. Let's help together. Your number on the old screen is so Freya. So now let's help together. SBTV Africa. I finna add more programs here, but when you warm up, you more ones here, but I'm here to mention. I'm going to say, I'm going to support support SBTV Africa. Madam Production Team, DJ Click, and Azu Sharon, the Lalak Boss, FM DJ, and I'm going to say, Tua, and I'm going to say, Tua, Makramo. Power Jet Car Battery, a power, keke. Me call.